ओके ठीक है, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। आई एम शेयरिंग माय स्क्रीन, राइट। आई होप माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू एवरीवन, राइट। ओके, सो आई विल क्विकली टेक ओवरव्यू व्हिच आई हैव एक्सप्लेन इन द लास्ट लेक्चर। इट वाज लिटिल बिट इन हरी बट आई विल कवर क्विकली। ओके, राइट, सो लेट अस गो टू दैट पार्ट। We were discussing about the modification in database, right? So we have studied so many different operations, basic operations, means fundamental operations, additional operations, extended relational algebra operations, right? So many things we have studied, but now we are going to study the modification in the database, means we are going to modify the database. So which are the operations which are involving, which are involved टू मॉडिफाई द डेटाबेस। डेटाबेस को मॉडिफाई कौन करता है? विच ऑपरेशन आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ डेटाबेस? सो दैट इंसर्ट, अपडेट एंड डिलीट, राइट। सो मीन्स वॉट वी आर डूइंग, वी आर एक्चुअली एडिंग, रिमूविंग और चेंजिंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द टेबल, दैट वी कॉल इज अ रिलेशन ऑफ द डेटाबेस। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑपरेशन इज अ डिलीशन। सो इफ वी परफॉर्म द डिलीशन, व्हेनेवर वी आर परफॉर्मिंग एनी एसक्यूएल क्वेरी, दैट डिलीट फ्रॉम, ओके, so internally it is converted to the relational algebra query, and what is happening internally, that we need to understand. So if I perform that delete operation, so it is expressed by like this, r minus e, where e is some expression, relational algebra expression, and the whatever value of this that is assigned to r. Okay, let's say I am performing c equal to a plus b, or even I can say in c language equal to even a plus c also, right? So whatever current value of C and value of A will be assigned to C likewise. So here what will happen, here deletion means it is assignment operation plus the set difference operation internally, okay. We will understand this by one example. So delete all details of Smith's account, delete all the details of Smith's account, right? So can you imagine our that six tables, which table is required? Out of our six tables, so every example of mine is based on the six tables only. So delete the okay, I'm opening here. The question is delete all details of Smith's account. Okay, here the Smith is not available, but you can understand that where Smith's detail can come in this table, in this six tables. Delete all the details of Smith's account. So what table do we require? Which table do we require to delete the details of Smith account? To delete the details of Smith account, chalo quickly, which tables do we require? Customer table has no information regarding the account details of the Smith. Smith means let's say Tarun. Okay, delete all the account details of the Tarun. Delete all the account details of the Tarun. Okay, account detail, right? Borrow detail has the loan, account detail and depositor, right? Account and depositor. So account and depositor is in the details regarding the Tarun's account details. So here we can do two things. Either I can join account with depositor table, I can either join account with depositor, or I can only use the depositor table, okay. But if I want all the details of Tarun, let's say, so that all the details will be available if I join account and depositor, let's say here Tarun is not a part of depositor, so I need to take the another example, that is the Tapan. Okay, Tarun is a borrower, so Tapan has account 102. Okay, 102 is at Dumas 6300. Right? Tapan here I can see. Tapan here has 102 and 102 Dumas 6300. So all the account details of the Tapan can be deleted. Okay, so what can we use? We can use a join account, join depositor, select operation apply. Select operation you can apply, let's say on the customer name. Okay, customer name is equal to, here I am writing Tapan. Right? And my tables are account, join, depositor. Okay, account is joined with depositor. So all the details of the Tapan who is available, which is available in account and depositor, will be deleted. Okay. Or if you simply want to delete the account detail method depositor, you can also use alone account also. This you can alone use the depositor alone also. Okay, alone depositor, because account table does not have account table does not have the name of the customer, or I will say account holder. Okay, so depositor table alone also you can use. If you use the depositor table, the query will be easy for you, right? So how it is, let's say I'm showing you, and that thing I will write here that is available. Okay, if I write only the depositor table, okay, so here it will be like depositor table. You can join also, but the query will be little bit complex. I simply want to show you the delete operation. So here sigma customer name equal to Tapan. So result will have the details of Tapan. Okay. Now what I will do? I will do the depositor. Right. Minus depositor, set difference this part. Okay. So depositor minus this part. Now I will assign this detail. Ab agar main iska result dekhunga, so this result does not have the detail of Tapan. So this detail I will assign to the again depositor table. Okay, as simple as that. So ultimately the depositor table, from the depositor table I have removed the details of Tapan. And the same thing I am assigning to the depositor table, like I am doing C equal to A plus C, right? So this is nothing but the assignment operation plus set difference operation performs the delete operation. I hope it is clear to you, right? I hope it is clear to you. Okay. Second thing, delete all the loans where amount is ranging from 0 to 50. Delete all the loans where amount is ranging from 0 to 50. So table, we have the loan, because loan has the amount column. Okay, loan has the amount column, so we will use the loan table, and the query is like that: sigma amount greater than or equal to zero and actually we will not use this, and we will use instead of this operation. Upside down B, that is the AND operation. Sigma amount greater than or equal to zero and amount should be less than or equal to 50 loan. So that thing I will subtract from the loan only. Okay, and same thing I will assign to loan. So loan will have no details of the tuples which are having amount 0 to 50. Okay, if the loan amount is between 0 to 50 rupees, it will be removed if it is there. Right, I hope it is clear to you. Okay, second is the update operation. Okay, sorry, insert operation. So insert operation, how can we do? Insert operation can be performed in the relational algebra using the assignment operation finally and union operation. So actually we have seen this when I was explaining you the concept of relational algebra and constant relation. When I had explained you the constant relation, at that time I explained you. Okay, so what you are going to do here you can take, let's say, any your table. Okay, your any table union any constant relation. Constant relation means constant some tuple, multiple tuples which are constant. Okay, that you are adding in the account, and same thing you are assigning to the account. So it is like C equal to C plus 5. It is like C equal to C plus 5. So same value, if variable C has some value, I am adding 5, and the same thing I am assigning C language statement. So same thing is happening here. Constant 5 is a constant. So constant table you are adding. Constant table means it is having the tuple. Okay, in terms of the block of the fixed tuples, multiple tuples you can add by applying the comma. Okay, and that is assigned to the account. So union operation and assignment operation. Same thing you can do for the depositor table. Any table you can add this kind of constant relation. So whenever you perform update operation, this kind of internal execution has happens. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. Next thing is the update operation. Now update operation uses the internally what I can say, generalized projection. Generalized projection is a extended relational algebra operation, right? So here you know generalized projection operation, right? Now what we are going to do, we are going to use the generalized project operation plus assignment operation. Assignment operation is mandatory because I will update the table and I will update the new table to the same table. Okay, I will update the new result which operation I have performed to the same table. So now here what will happen, f of I is f1 f2 f3 and I. So generalized projection of R, what is f1 f2 f of I is ith attribute of R if ith attribute is not to be updated, and expression involving only constants and attributes of R that gives new attribute. Okay, so ya to f1 f2 jo hai that can be a old value that is not updated, or that can be a new value, right? f1 f2 or fn, that can be a new old value that is not updated, or that can be a new value. But new value should involve only the constants and arithmetic operations only. So we will see that how we can do that by considering the example. Interest of 5% is given to all the account holders. Interest of 5% is given to all the account holders means balance of all the accounts will be increased by 5%. So can you tell me which table do I require increase the balance of all the account holders by 5%? Can you tell me which table is required? Tell me quickly, if question is balance of all accounts to be increased by 5%. Okay, so balance means balance of all accounts. So that is the meaning, that account table. Okay, we will requiring account table, right? So what we are going to do here, I will write query. Okay, to simply show you, here I am writing account table has the details, right? So I will perform pi. Now let's say we have the three columns. One is the account number. I will make a little bit account number. Okay. Second thing is branch name, and third is the balance. So balance, what we will do? We will take balance into 1.05, because I am adding previously I had told you I am increasing the by 5%. Okay, that is I am applying to the account table, right? And balance. Okay, balance multiplied by 1.05. 1.05 means 5% increment to the balance. And same thing I will assign to the account table. Are you getting? Same thing I will assign to the account table. So this value of balance will be updated and assigned to the account table. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, so the same thing I have done here. You can see my query that is written by me, and here, okay, below above that I have written in by pen on the page. Okay, so you can understand it. Second thing, if I wish, okay, if I wish that there are some condition I am giving, okay, that I want to see this question. I want to change the account balance, okay, by 6% whose balance is more than 10,000, and others I want to provide 5% increment in the balance. Okay, means the balance, if balance is more than 10,000, I will provide the 10,000. I will provide 6% increment. If the balance is less than 10,000, I will provide 5% increment. Right? So there is two different things. If the balance is more than 10,000, I will provide 6% increment. If the balance is less than 10,000, I will provide 5% increment. So how can I write that query? So this is the answer. First, I will do two partition. Okay? That if the balance is greater than 10,000, then I will perform balance into 1.06, 6% increment. Second, union, okay, of what? If the balance is less than or equal to 10,000, so only increment by 5%. Okay, so this is one part. This is one part. This is second part. Okay. One part is regarding greater than 10,000 and 6% increment. Second is less than 10,000 and 5% increment. I am making union of all. And finally, assignment to the account table. Finally, assignment to the account table. I hope you are getting the concept, what I am trying to say. Right? First part is discussing about the, giving me result about if the balance is greater than 10,000, then add the 6% in the balance. Second part is discussing or giving the result about if the balance is less than or equal to 10,000, then add the 5% interest and making union of both, and then in last assigning to the account keeper. Right? Okay. Final one point I need to discuss about the integrity constraints. Actually, this is a part of unit 1, but still I will take quickly. So integrity constraints are very important to be satisfied for the any database consistency. Integrity constraint must be satisfied for any database consistency. Okay, so first a domain constraint. Domain means, I told you, the set of permitted values. Right, set of permitted values. So let's say if I say age, my age is minus 25. So is that allowed? No, that is not allowed. Right? Even if I say my account number is minus 105, so that is also not allowed logically. If I say my balance is minus 4800, that is also not correct logically. So if I try to add one data, let's say 103 Vastrapur and balance is minus 4800, the database should not allow me to add it. That is called as the domain integrity. It should not allow me to add this kind of minus values. You know in SQL. If you know in practical 3, if you want to add the null value and we have provided the data, we have provided the constraint that it is not null. So it will not allow you to add the null value. Agar not null constraint diya hai, to null value add nahi kar paoge. So same thing like this. Domain constraint minus 4800 balance mein add nahi kar sakte. Theek hai? Simple like that. You cannot add the value other than the set of permitted values. Means domain ke bahar add nahi kar sakte. Referential integrity. So referential integrity means I am talking about the foreign key. Okay, primary key of one table is referenced by the another table. Primary key of one table is referenced by the another table. So if, let's say here, primary key, okay, what is the primary key? Account number is primary key 101101. Right? Now if I delete account number from here, so means this tuple I am deleting. So here, from here it is deleted, but here it remains. From here 101 detail is deleted, but here it remains. So now it can create confusion because Trupti has account number 101. So what is his branch? What is her branch? What is her amount account balance? I don't know because this tuple is deleted and this tuple is not deleted. So it creates a integrity referential integrity because this account number is referencing here. So that creates a problem. So if I so two possible solutions. If I am deleting this, delete this tuple also. Or second solution, you do not allow to delete this tuple alone. Do not allow to delete this tuple alone. There are two solutions of this problem, right? So integrity, referential integrity must be maintained. I hope it is clear to you. Third thing is a assertion. Assertion means there is some extra conditions that you can impose on the database. Let's say I am imposing the condition that account balance, in generally that is happens in the bank, account balance should be greater than 1000 in your bank. Means minimum 1000 balance you need to maintain in your bank. So whenever you are opening your bank account, it will directly tell you that you provide the check of 1000 or cash of 1000 so that it, he or she can deposit 1000 at least. Okay. So always there is some condition. Actually balance greater than 0 rupees is also okay. Logically, but here there are some extra conditions that balance should be greater than 1000. So this kind of assertions are required, extra conditions we call as assertion. So that should be also satisfied whenever you are creating any database. Like I am creating the database of bank management system, and my condition is that minimum bank balance should be 1000. So if you are adding some balance, let's say 103 Vastrapur, if you are adding some balance which is 4400, so it will not allow you to add. It will not allow you to add. As simple as that. This is called as the assertion. And assertion is a generalized word than the referential integrity and domain constraint. Okay. So domain constraint and referential integrity are a part of or subcategory of the assertion. Right. So I hope you understand. Fourth is the authorization. There are two things, authentication and authorization. Right. So what do you mean by authentication? Authentication means you are authenticated to do open this thing. Let's say you have access to our ERP. Okay, you are adding your, means you are checking your enrollment number, you are adding your details, your photo, your 10, 12, your diploma details. So you are logging into the ERP, means that erp.ganpatiuniversity.ac.in, means you are authenticated person to open it, but you are not authorized to change the thing. Let's say, can you do that? I don't want the field of a birth date. I want to remove it. I want to remove the field of birth date. Can you do that? No, you cannot do that. So means you are not authorized to do that. You are authenticated, but you are not authorized to do that. That thing can only be done by the some university person only. Okay. So authorization means it will defer you from the some. It will defer you from the permission rights. Different types of user have which type of permission that it provides. So generally there is read authorization, insert authorization, update authorization, delete authorization. There are different types of authorizations available. So based on the type of user, one or more type of authorization is allowed in the database. Okay, one or more type of authorization is allowed. Now in DDL, you know SQL is divided into four parts: DDL, DML, DCL and TCL. Data definition language, data manipulation language, data control language and transaction control language. So DDL, data definition language, what happens in the data definition language, we are adding the details of the table. Okay, means we are adding the details like table attribute name, its data type and its size. This thing we are providing for every table. And DDL. So DDL means what? We are writing the command like create table, order table, truncate table. Okay, so we are changing the structure or we are creating the structure of database tables. So the content of the DDL is placed into the data dictionary. Content of DDL is placed into the data dictionary, and data dictionary is called as a metadata. Metadata means data about data. Content of DDL is placed into the data dictionary, and data dictionary is called as the metadata. Okay, metadata means data about data. So data about data means table contains data, but what is the detail of table? So that is its attribute name, means the column name, its data type and size. So these things are stored into the data dictionary. ओके डेटा डिक्शनरी में डेटा कहाँ से आता है, डेटा डिक्शनरी गेट्स द डेटा फ्रॉम डीडीएल कमांड, क्रिएट, ऑल्टर, ट्रंकेट. सो डेटा डिक्शनरी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द डेटा अबाउट डेटा मीन मेटा डेटा. वाई, बिकॉज दिस इज द डेटा अबाउट टेबल, इट इज द डेटा अबाउट टेबल. ओके एंड दिस टेबल कंटेन्स व्हाट, डेटा, राइट, टेबल कंटेन्स डेटा एंड दिस इज द डेटा अबाउट द टेबल. सो डेटा अबाउट डेटा. So this is all about the unit 2. Now we will see, I hope you do not have any query regarding here the unit 2. Okay. DDL is not same as DML. DML means select, insert, update operation. Select, insert, update and delete operation. DDL means alter, create, truncate table operations. Right? So now we will quickly see one or two exercises regarding the DDL, relational algebra queries. Okay, so write this name of the table in your notebook quickly and we are finding out the answers. You have to give me the answer, okay, if possible in the chat box. If that is a pi operation, so you can write pi like this. Okay, you do not have, let's say, that pi and symbol, so you can write pi, you can write sigma, okay, like words. Okay, you can use union operation. So tell me the quick answers of the questions so that you can understand this relational algebra queries in the better way. Okay, so consider these tables, books, students, author, borrow, has written, describes. Quickly understand this. Okay. Quickly write in your notebook. Okay, so let us understand the query. List the year and title of each book. List the year and title of each book. Okay, this is the detail regarding the books and the books written by the author. Plus, student has borrowed some books. So you can say it is some kind of basic part of a library management system. Book is written by some author and book is borrowed by the student. Okay, so has written means it is written by some author. A name means author name. And describes means a description about book in terms of keywords. Right, author means author name and address. Address means city name. This is the details of students. Major means major subject and this is the details of books. Right, so borrow means books borrowed by the student on student ID, book ID and date on which date he has borrowed. Right? Okay. So let us continue. The first question, this is the year and title of each book. This is the year and title of each book. So it is containing which table, title and year. So book table. So here pi, title, comma year and book table. This is the year and title of each book. Okay, this is the year and title of each book. I hope it is visible to you. Hello, is there any issue? Right, so let's move ahead. List all information about the student whose major is CS. List all information about student whose major is CS. Write quickly the answer in your chat box. List all information about student whose major is CS. List all information about student, major is CS. Okay, you can write like sigma, SIGMS, sigma or pi, 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 likewise. Give me quick answer. We need to complete this. We have two exercises. Chalo, fast. List all information about student whose major is CS. Here, this is the part. Major is CS. Chalo, jaldi. Okay, pi student sigma major is equal to CS. Correct. For student, correct. Pi sigma major equal to CS, then student. So we'll write this query like this quickly. Sigma major is equal to CS, okay, and this is the answer. Table is student. you need to find out the table. Okay, quickly go towards the next. Okay, list all students whose books they can buy. Okay, answer is given here. List all the students which books they can buy. List all the students which books they can buy means a student have the possibility of buying which different books. So here we are trying out the possibility. So we have taken the Cartesian product of the student table and books. List all the students with books they want to buy. List all the students with books they want to buy. So all the possibilities. Okay, sorry, they want to buy, they can buy. List all the students with books they can buy. So here student cross join or Cartesian product books, that will give you all the possibilities, right? This is as simple as that. Okay, list all the books published by McGraw-Hill publication before 1990. List all the books published by McGraw-Hill publication before 1990. So this is the book's table details. Tell me the answer of question D. List all the books published by McGraw-Hill. McGraw-Hill is a publication. Okay, and here 1990. Which table is required? This table is required, book table. Okay, so tell me the query. No, in first question, pi kyun aayega? Pi ki zarur nahi hai. In C question, pi is not required. In question C, pi is not required. Okay, sigma publisher equal to McGraw-Hill, very good. But you need two conditions. Year is also given. Year is also given. So what is that? Year is also given. Year should be greater than 1990. So how can I add this? Before less than 1990. Very good. Okay, so you can add two things. Here is the answer. Publisher is Tata McGraw-Hill. Okay, and year and operation. Year is less than 1990. Table is books. Sigma operation. Publisher is McGraw-Hill. Year 1990. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. I will share this PDF with you for the reference purpose. Okay, E question. List the names of those authors who are living in Paris. Paris means address. Address column. List name of those authors who live in Paris. Quickly. List table. Simple query is that. Three not list. It is working. E question. List name of those authors who live in Paris. Very good. Sigma address equal to Paris and table author. Very good. Okay. So sigma address equal to Paris author and name of means pi name. Pi name is given because name of the author is required. So A name. Okay. It is also on not only name. It is actually A name. A name. That is A name. Pi A name. Sigma address equal to Paris and author. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. Very simple questions. Next, list the name F. List the names of here. Students who are older than 30 age and who are not studying CS. Students who are older than that age 30 and who are not studying CS. Okay, students who are older than 30 age, who are not studying CS. So which table do we require? Age. It is talking about age and major CS. The subject should not be CS and age should be greater than 30. What is the query? Student table. What is the query? Tell me the query. Quickly. Pi sigma is greater than 30, major equal to CS student. Very good. But little bit, there are two ways you can do. Major should not be equal to CS. Okay. Major should not be equal to CS. So you can do this question solved using two things. One is using set difference operation or using the answer you are giving, AND operation. Okay. AND operation and set difference operation. Right. So two options are available. One is the using set difference operation. So here sigma age greater than, just a moment, okay, sigma is greater than 30, so that is on student table, and accept the student names. Then second thing, okay, again yes, again pi sigma major is ts student, pi student name, sigma 30 student. So here we have the detail of students, we have the age more than 30, that difference minus student we have who have taken the major as ts. So first find the list of students who have age greater than 30 minus list of students who have major ts. So that is the using set difference operation you can do. Another thing, you are giving the answer that answer we will consider, okay. That is the answer here, pi student name is greater than 30, major is not equal, less than or greater than is not equal to CS and student. I hope this question means letters are visible, little bit blurry, but I think you can visualize. Pi student name where A is greater than 30, sigma operation, and major is not equal to CS student. Okay, and operation. Two ways you can write this query. Okay, rename the author name in relation author to name. Okay. This is the way that has been written, but I will say the new way, that is the row author name. Author name means we have to change the A name to name. I want to change the name of the column. Okay, so I will take a new name of the table is T, and I will change the name to name instead of A name. This is the new way, this is the older way. So don't consider this, don't consider this. Okay, I am giving you the new way. T name comma address in the author table, sorry, yes, author table, okay, address, and this is applied to the table which author. So this is the actual query which I am writing right now. Okay, this is the actual query. Right, raw T name, address, author name. I hope you, it is clear to you. Okay, right. So next is the find list of names of all students who borrowed a book and who are in CS major. H question, list all the names of, list names of all the students who borrowed a book and who are in CS major. So I will give you the table details, these are the table details in front of you. Name of all the students who borrowed a book and who are in CS major. So which table do we require? Name of students who borrowed a book and who are in CS major. Which table do we require? We require two tables. Which are the tables? Borrow and student. Very good. Borrow and student. Okay. So see the query. Here you can apply natural join also instead of the Cartesian product. So natural join between student and borrow, and you can apply the condition major equal to CS. Okay, our condition is major equal to CS. Okay, student natural join borrow, major equal to CS, pi student name. Student natural join borrow, major equal to CS, pi student name. This condition is not required. This this part is not required if I am performing natural join. Okay. I list title, list the title of the book written by author Bala Goswami. List title of the book written by author Bala Goswami. Okay, so which are the tables do we require? Title of the book. So title is here. Okay. And written by author Bala Goswami. So author name you will require. Okay, sorry. Here it is. Author name has written. Author name and book ID. Okay, so we require title, author name, and book ID. Right? Book ID, why? Because we want to compare this one. So book ID, title, and has written. So has written and books, we need to join the two tables, and we will apply the condition of the author Bala Goswami. Okay, I hope you are getting this. Yes, book. So that is the books has written. These are the which means joining of the table. Okay, this condition is not required if you perform the natural join. Author name is Bala Guru Swami and pi title. Okay, books natural join has written, author name Bala Guru Swami and pi title. I hope you are getting right. This book ID comparison is not required. Okay, list each book with keyword. List each book with keyword. So keyword is the given here. Keyword is given here. Describes book ID and keyword. So list each book with keyword. So book ID, keyword. Okay. But if you want the name of the book title, so you need to join book and the describe. If you want the name of the book, you need book ID, keyword and title. So you need two tables: books and describes. Right. Okay, so here books and describes, right? Natural join. List each book with keyword. List each book with keyword. I hope you are getting. You are getting this question. List each book with keyword. Keyword means, let's say some book is using the keyword. Let's say I will use for the C language. Okay, so for C language, let's say token, identifier. These are some keywords. Okay. Or let's say procedural programming, or let's say for looping statement, control statement. These words are, let's say, keywords. So this kind of words we are using. So that is a part of describe. Okay. And just a moment. And two tables we require: describe and books. Because describe as the keyword term, and if I want title, then I need books table. If I need join ID, then describe table is alone is okay. If I need only book ID, then describe table alone is okay. Right? Remember, book ID is given in the describe table. Okay. Next question. List the author of the book the student Smith has borrowed. Yes. List the author of the book the student Smith has borrowed. List the author of the book the student Smith has borrowed. Means, understand. Student Smith has borrowed some books. Who is the author of the book? Smith has borrowed some books. Who is the author of the book? So we need the borrow. Okay, first of all, student borrow, because student has borrowed some book. Now Smith, we need student name. So student name is given in student table. Okay, student name is given. I am writing triangle. So borrow is required because student has borrowed something. Student name is required. The student table is also required, but I need author name also. I need author name also. Okay, so where is the author name? I need the table has written. Okay, I need the table has written. So we need three tables: student, borrow, and has written. Because I need the name of author. Why I have not taken table author? See, I will join student table and borrow table using the student ID and this student ID, common column. Then I will join the borrow table, that is the book ID, and has written book ID, that is the common column. So natural join is possible between borrow, has written, and student. And I will apply the constraint sigma student equal to, sorry, student name equal to Smith. Okay, so simply I think you are getting the terms what I am saying. Okay, author, no author are not required. Are you getting which tables you require? Student, borrow, and has written. Borrow, has. Are you getting doubt in the this name of for the books which are borrowed by the Smith? This is the name of authors which are borrowed by the Smith. Okay. So are you getting why I am taking the table? Has written. Okay. Why I'm taking the table has written? Because has written has the detail of author name and book ID. Borrow has the detail of borrowing by student. Student name is required because Smith is there. So student name is only inside the student table. There is no another table who has the student name column. Okay. So student lagega. Borrow is required because borrowing, student is borrowing. So details are required. Has written because author name. I require author name, right? Okay. Just 2 minutes. Other faculty those who have joined. Just 2 minutes. Okay. So I will write this query in this way here. Okay. Joining of let's say natural join of which are the tables I am taking. One is a student borrow and has returned. Okay, one is a student borrow and has returned. Right. So I will write student table, natural join, borrow table. Okay, and here it is has returned. Has return table. Right, this type of table join and perform, and I will apply the condition sigma in the main is equal to Smith. Okay. If you want to perform any whoever has joined the new domain. Okay, so Smith, right? So this is the name of just a moment. This is the query. Okay, just 2 minutes, right? Okay. Next question: which book have the both keyword database and programming? Which book have both keyword database and programming? Okay, so which book has the both keyword? One is database and another one is programming. Which book has both keyword database and programming? Okay, so which table do we require? We require keyword means describe. We need describe. Okay, this table and which book have. So describe table can do anything. Means book ID is given. But if you want the title of the book also, so you need book table also. So describe table and book table. Describe table and book table. Which book has the keyword programming and database? So you can do this with two ways: intersection operation also and natural join operation also. Okay, natural join operation also. Okay, so here it is given. Book. Okay, here it is given using set difference, but I will give you using the intersection operation. That is very simpler. Okay, so if you don't understand, which book have keyword database and programming, right? So we write query here. Don't worry. First, the sigma keyword is okay. Keyword is equal to database. Okay, for the table, let's say which is the table name. That is table name has returned. Sorry, here it is the describe. Okay, describe. Okay, and I will apply the intersection. Okay, sigma keyword equals to programming. Okay, I am writing in short programming, and table name is same. Okay, table name is same, describe. Clear? So intersection of this keyword is database, and second intersection of this describe. Using this you can answer this query: who have both keyword database and programming? I hope it is clear to you. So we have solved all the question of this example, right? There is exam exercise this too also. You try it on your own. The answers are given. Exercise 2 answers are given. This is for your reference. So you will have the very good, let's say, practice of the relational algebra query, right? I hope there is no doubt. Okay. Now, just two things I want to show you. I'm stopping my. Just a moment. Wait. I need to share my screen. Just a moment. Okay. Two more things I need to tell you about the assignment. Assignment one is I will give you the link of the assignment one. Okay, this is the link of assignment one. Sorry, and first internal syllabus. So first internal syllabus is up to the point I have covered today. Okay, so unit one and two plus practical SQL queries and relational algebra queries. Okay. Unit 1, 2, SQL queries and relational algebra queries. So prepare for the SQL queries. For SQL queries, up to the practical 2. Up to the practical 2. And for relational algebra queries, whatever is covered in our class. Okay. Unit 1, 2, plus SQL queries of practical 2, up to practical 2 and relational algebra queries. I hope it is clear. Normalization unit, unit 4. Explained by the Prachi madam. So these topics are written. I will give you this link. Okay, right now I am copying this thing and I will write in the chat box. Okay, question answer session. You can use it later on also. I will provide you, no issue. So I will send you the this thing. Okay, I am keeping the recording link and everything in the material also in the recording the table. Don't worry. Second thing about the assignment. So assignment one is given here. And the last date is 15 October for the assignment one. I will give this, I am giving this link also, but I am going to change this assignment. So don't write right now. Don't write right now, later on. After your internal exam, you can write. Okay. So I have already provided the syllabus of internal exam one and assignment one. Right. Okay. So then. Thank you from my side. I hope you do not have any doubt regarding DBMS. Okay. Kindly, sir, please stop the recording and I will leave now.
Hello, now okay. input about the voice is not clear.
And